الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. InsyaAllah saya boleh hadir ni. Saya berhenti bernama
Syah.
Thank you for calling me. That goes to Sakina Ika. Mana Ika?
These
two young ladies were. Oh, kalau belakang jauh sangat, come forward. I don't bark, I don't bite. In my class, people tak takut saya, except that I close my doors at 8 o'clock sharp. Sebab dalam bar, I ask them to go back home. That's all. But once they're in class, they enjoy my class, I think, most of them, if not all. Why? For three reasons. Number one, when I'm in class, when you keep quiet, when I ask questions, I say silence is not golden. Number two, you give wrong answers, I appreciate wrong answers. And number three, if you give right answers, you get 2 ringgit or 4 ringgit for me. For one right answer. But not here. You're all richer than us in Sabri. Jadi, saya lupa mengucapkan dengan Assalamualaikum dulu. Alhamdulillah, Amin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jadi pertama saya rafakkan kesyukuran Alhamdulillah Alamin wassalamu ala syafil adiyya wa mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. First apologies, when I was very young like you, I learned that in giving speeches you don't give excuses. But this time I got to give an excuse. Rarely do I give excuses. Number one, I've been notified about this talk 3 days ago. So I didn't prepare anything great. Number two days ago, I was being notified that I've got to launch a whole day meeting of wanita ikram, pertemuan ikram Malaysia, which I'm the Timbalan president, 300 of them this morning. So I got to launch. There must be a tax. Jadi, so you know where you stand. Alhamdulillah, I'm here, and I'm half an hour late. Should be 2:30. Anyway, we start right away. There are around 18 pages or 20 pages of slides. Now, rule number one when you do slides, I teach this to my students in the first month of their first year, first week of the first year. When you write slides, when you do slides, when you prepare slides, best is you paginate the slides, like me. Yeah? First page pun ada paginate. First page tak ada apa. And then you tell your audience how many slides will that be. I think it's around 18 slides. 20, so that you can sleep and wake up at slide number 17. 18 slides. And 99% of the time when I say that, people don't go to sleep. Bila kita kata ya, kita jangan tidur, orang tidur. Bila kita suruh tidur, orang nak tidur. So not many slides, but I want to show you some photos at the end, how super Muslims survive and excel in this world. No names, no great Muslims names, but groups of Muslims, how they survive and how they withstand suffering. To me, these are super Muslims. Not in like our country where there is no hurricane, no gempa bumi, no wars, nothing, except political wars. I've been hunger around some parts of the world, termasuk Sakina's dad. I think there's another reason why I talk to medical students. Nowadays, when medical students call me, I say, please contact 1, 2, or 3. These are all my juniors. Because I don't take contracts for medical students like today. Either you're lucky or when you're lucky. But the reason being, in Nippon, part of the psychology, when Prof. Zabidi called me, it's difficult for me to say no. Because we were in the same mercy a mission, different month. Yeah, the first one, he was in group number 4, I was in group number 2 of Mercy Malaysia going to Kosovo, way back in 1999. We got that kinship. And of course, I know him for a long time. Yeah? The last time we met was in Singapore, in the Asia Pacific Conference. All right. The topic is funny. Tak pernah saya diberi topik begini, ya. Super Muslim. To me, a Muslim is a Muslim. But you want super, tak apalah kita super shell, super petrol, apa. This morning, I was telling to makcik-makcik who have been in Tawah for a long, long time, 300 of them, wanita, a few pakcik, around 15 pakcik, the rest of wanita. And I say, petang ni nak cakap dengan IMU. Because I was talking about them, these are people who have been involved in Islamic work for many decades, some of them. Alhamdulillah, I've been involved in Islamic work since 1975 when I was a medical student. Yeah? So how many decades? I'm 60 years old now. Yeah. So I told these bachi-bachi, onyibachi, many of them, and some of the adi, I say that when I look at you, I remember last night and this morning, I was thinking that every one of you are thinking for 2 to 5 human beings of this earth. I was talking to them. That you are supermen and superwomen, and you are carrying the burden of 2 to 5 human beings of this earth. Why? Because you think about Palestine. You think about the suffering in USA. You think about the Muslims here and there. You think about humanitarian work. You think about the injustices of the world. Whereas majority of human beings prefer to be lulled. Di lena kan dengan songs, music. I purposely on that music, with Turkish music. I bought the CD. My wife showed me the CD dekat, and then bought dekat Istanbul, for example, that was 3 months ago. It's good for music therapy. Music therapy is music therapy. It's not to lull the mind, it's for therapy. So that you can be revived and work harder, not to be lulled into inaction. Yeah, inaction. But again, it is a pleasure to talk to mostly medical students here, pharmacy students, tak ada sini. Ada dentistry, tak ada pharmacy dentistry, apa lagi ada? Sorry?
Medical
science.
Biomed, yes. I mean, it's nice talking to biomed, science students, medical students, because it's easier to talk, perhaps, in some way. The spirit is now. Don't wait until when I graduate, I do this. When I graduate, because most 10 people who said that in the past, maybe one will survive. The rest will be lulled. Lena kan dengan dunia ni. Dunia ni memang cukup menarik. But we believe that there is no true happiness in this world. I was saying this to your pakcik this morning. Tidak ada kebahagiaan hakiki dalam hidup ini. Tidak ada kedukaan hakiki dalam hidup ini. The real kedukaan hakiki di neraka nanti. Itu kedukaan hakiki. Kebahagiaan hakiki di syurga nanti. Because in the morning you will be happy. In the afternoon you will be sad. And tomorrow morning you will be happy again. Or sad. You will be sad for a week and then happy. So, what are the hakiki? All illusion in this world. But illusion or not, we have to go through this world and survive and excel. Next, please. This is our mission, our story, our mission. The story of Islam and Muslims is a story shared by countless multitudes. Ramai manusia. Through the ages, amongst many peoples, peoples can be plural. When and why? When we refer to tribes, Malaysian people, Tawi Malaysian peoples. Tapi kita boleh kata Muslim peoples, because there are Muslims in Kosovo, there are Muslims in Bosnia, there are Muslims in China, there are Muslims in USA, so Muslim peoples. In the main, it is a story about us, those who incense incessantly, unstoppingly, strive to be fearful of Allah, in love with Him. You must fear Allah and love Allah. Itu namanya taqwa. Kalau takut Allah, is khawf Allah, takut Allah. Yeah? Innama yashallah min ibadihil ulama. Sungguhnya di kalangan hamba-hambaku, Allah kata, yang takut adalah di kalangan ulama. Ulama adalah bukan ulama lulus Azhar saja, atau dari Akademi Islam UN. Ulama adalah mereka yang mengetahui ma'rifatullah, tahu tentang Allah, dan dia akan takut. At the same time, takut not enough. Many pious Muslims say that there's a higher level compared to takut, fear, which is what? Which is love. You must be falling in love with Allah. You sleep for His love, you wake up for His love, you love your wife, your husband, your parents for His love. Then the meaning in this life will be unfathomable. Tak boleh diukur makna dalam hidup ini, keindahannya dalam hidup ini. Ya? Kalau tak, everything is illusion, meaningless. And also in love with His Prophet. You don't fear the Prophet. You are in love with the Prophet, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Because the Prophet is Habibullah, kekasih Allah. And if you are in love with the Prophet, then you are in love with Allah. Life becomes easier that way. And we are also involved in civilizing the world. And our civilization has led the world. It is not only for the courageous. This mission is not only for the courageous, yang berani. But it is also for the faint-hearted to become courageous. Kata-kata, it is not for the faint-hearted. Bukan orang yang lemah, bukan lemah jantung, lemah semangat, lemah ini. Tapi orang yang penakut pun dengan Islam, dia akan menjadi berani. Okay, next please. This Islam is a civilization eclipsed, gerhana. Dia hanya gerhana, cuma gerhana lambat sikit, lama sikit. Like all eclipses, this eclipse of Islam is gradually disappearing. Yang akan muncul, Islam macam gerhana bulan kan. Gerhana bulan ni maknanya apa? Apa yang tertutup? Gerhana matahari apa yang tertutup?
Matahari.
Really, I don't know. Matahari yang tertutup kan? You can see it. And then it will appear. So Islam is being eclipsed. By what? By other forces. By other powers. But it is gradually appearing now. You see, you're lucky. You're lucky because when we were students like you, medical students, all over the world, the University of Malaya, the UKM, the year was 1973, yeah? The Egypt where I was, the Australia, some friends studied in Australia, although alhamdulillah I later on studied in Monash and taught Monash University students. Monash, bukan Salwe, tak payah Salwe, tapi tak payah di Monash. My postgraduate and sub-specialty. Yeah. And then I was teaching Monash medical students then. But when we're talking about your age, Masa tu, we were just, the Muslim nations were just called free nations. But they were not free because most of the Muslim nations were ruled by dictators. 1973, 1972. Now, the year 2012, we see dictators falling one by one. And you are lucky because you witnessed this when you were young. So you can imagine, inshallah, when you are old as me, standing somewhere or sitting somewhere, or perhaps one or two of you be in the grave, can imagine the Muslim nations will be better than now, inshallah. Because there's only one way to be better. It cannot be regressed by it. It's the nature of things. When people in the 50s, in the 40s, in the 30s, in the 20s were semangat and want to be with Islam, want to be following Allah's rule and following the Sunnah of the Prophet, inshallah, there's only one way, betterment. But there'll be a lot of resistance from the powers of the world that are against Islam. But again, as I said, it'll be only one way, inshallah, betterment. So you just watch my words, yeah? Because I may not see you all. I don't remember your names, your faces. Perhaps two or three or four I did. After that, I forget on tour. But remember these words of mine. That when you are old as me, inshallah, the world is better, and Islam will be better, and the Muslim nation will be better. Yeah. Tapi ada satu syarat, that all of you work hard.